In view of the worsening insecurity in the country, in all states of the Federation of Abuja, it is feared that the country may break up or engage in a full-scale war. And only Labour and other progressive forces can stop this dangerous trend that we are witnessing in our country. A retired general who once warned that no nation survived two civil wars has now called on Nigerians to rise up and defend themselves on the ground that the armed forces and the police have compromised the security of the nation. This particular general, if you must know, was the chief of army staff when in the 70s, under Obasanjo, you had Uge Priors, Oshodi Riots, Fela South, Bond, and you know, these guys were just killing. And while he was Minister of Defense under Obasanjo, you had Odi invasion in Bayelsa, Zaki Biang in Benue State, and of course, his own role in the Junkun, you know, thief war, you know, between Taraba and Benue State. And this was a guy who said he got an air block, move across to the offshore. He sold the thing, kept enough for his family, and publicly disclosed, I don't know what to do with $500 million. Many youth bodies have killed behind the members of the ruling class, agitating for the balkanization of the country. Others who are disenchanted with unemployment, illiteracy and poverty, traceable to the implementation of neoliberal economic policies, have engaged in crimes such as armed robbery, banditry, terrorism, drug trafficking, advanced field fraud, internet fraud, prostitution, and human trafficking. The failure of the regime to control the violent attacks on farmers and destruction of farms by a group bearing AK-47 rifles, operating as elders and lopsided appointment by the Buhari regime, have fueled the separatist agenda of several groups in the country. In spite of the program of his own party, that is the APC, for restructuring of power devolution from the center to the other federated unit, President Buhari has sworn arrogantly to defend the status quo. We fought the civil war. We're not going to allow anybody to break up the country. But the country is breaking on their heads. A regime that had negotiated and granted amnesty to terrorists and bandits in the recent past has rejected the call for dialogue with all separatist bodies. The House of Representatives has just passed a resolution. A jocular, the height of recent jokes, calling on President Buhari to declare a state of emergency to combat insecurity in the country. What do you mean by state of emergency? Because anytime there is a problem, declare a state of emergency on education, declare a state of emergency on that, meaning what? Address the problems of insecurity in our country. But what did they say? Oh, we want to give him enormous powers to restore law and order in the country. And I'm asking here, but without declaring a state of emergency, has President Buhari not declared and authorized the armed forces to wage a full-scale war on communities in Kaduna, Zamfara, Katsina, Niger, Akwa Ibom, Imo, Ebonyi, Benue, and Taraba State in order to fish out terrorists and bandits? Have a number of militias and vigilante groups now retaliated by attacking and killing scores of military and police personnel? The latest was that the president, like his predecessor, General Lucas Obasanjo, ordered that all bandits, all headers, should be shot on sight. Illegally. Because there is a provision of our law dealing with illegal possession of firearms, murder and others. You will have to arrest criminal elements and put them on trial. No president has the power to order criminal suspects to be extrajudicially executed. But that was meant to give the impression that the regime has now decided to put an end to this form of criminality. It is our submission that several decades of legacy of misrule and bad governance, corruption and diversion of the Commonwealth and anti-people's policies have led to the ascendancy of insecurity in the country. No part of Nigeria is safe today, as marauders have been abducting people, including undergraduates, secondary school students, and even primary school pupils. We have found that armed bandits, armed insurgents, armed herders, armed militias, armed coaches, armed robbers, and armed kidnappers lay siege to the country, exercising varying degrees of suzerainty over large swaths of the territory of the country. The state is incapable of ending kidnapping or rescuing abducted citizens and foreigners. In the circumstance, ransom is paid by family members and friends to secure the release of victims of abductions from captivity. Just yesterday, the governor of Niger State, an APC governor, warned the people in Abuja, the people in the village, that these boys are coming because they are just a few kilometers away from Abuja and that they are hosting the flag of Boko Haram. Nobody has denied such, you know, statement. It is crystal clear that the neo-colonial state has lost the monopoly of violence to the armed gangs, and that happens only in banana republics or failed states. Apart from the manipulation of ethnicity and religion and use of brute force, the federal and state governments have run out of ideas and are incapable of finding lasting solutions to the worsening security challenge in the country. The negotiations between bandits in power and bandits in the bush have yielded no positive results. Since 2009, the armed forces have been waging the counter-insurgency operations in the Northeast region, realizing that the armed forces are ill-equipped and ill-motivated. The immediate past Chief of Army Staff, General Yusuf Buratai, has predicted that the war on terror will last for another period of 20 years. That was what he told the Senate. Without challenging him, he said, go and become an ambassador representing our country. Since the Nigerian police force has been demobilized deliberately from maintaining law and order by successive regimes, the overstretched armed forces have been deployed and mandated to free many communities that have been overrun by nihilist forces in the various states. Having been overwhelmed by the security challenge, the ruling class will not hesitate to sabotage the democratic process or plunge the country into another civil war. These guys will call the military when they are tired. Mark it.